Hello sir, today there's a event was for the No India tourism culture. We have you have Indian Embassy and all other tourism industry has been conducted this one. It was really it is a great opportunity to introduce our Indian culture and Indian history to the Gulf and Kuwait people. I think it was a first meeting with like open this thing for the Indian history. I think so when you came here and you have opened the tourism culture to our India. How you are feeling about these things? Our India, incredible India will go with this all together.
No, India and Kuwait are not strangers to each other. We are friendly countries and we have a historical relationship that goes back centuries. And there's a lot of goodwill between the two countries, two governments, two people. And as you know, we are the largest expatriate community in Kuwait. And it doesn't happen if Kuwaiti people and Kuwaiti government and Kuwaiti leadership, they don't trust the community or they don't have confidence in the community. So our relationship is wonderful.
Yeah.
And in fact, as ambassador, I would like to express my gratitude for taking this opportunity to the Kuwaiti government and the leadership and the people for the kind of trust and confidence and the friendship and the warmth that they give to our Indian community. Having said that, coming to tourism, unfortunately, there is plenty of potential, given the intensity of the relationship, the historicity of the relationship, but the number of tourists going from Kuwait to India, I would say, is not proportionate to the intensity of the relationship.
Yes.
So that is what we are trying to bridge. That gap has to be bridged.
Yeah.
I would think one of the main reasons is lack of information and lack of awareness about India, particularly among the younger generations of Kuwait. Because the older generations, they have traveled to India, they were trading with India, they have a lot of fondness for India and familiarity with India. But the younger generations have to be informed about the nature of our relationship, the intensity of our relationship, and also what India offers as a tourism destination. The diversity that India offers in every sense of the term, not just the people, diversity of, you know, the cultural diversity, but the topography, for example, as I was mentioning, where in the world you will see snow mountains just a few hundred kilometers away from a desert. And you go to the south, the kind of scenic beauty that you see in Kerala or Goa. On the one hand, you have beaches, and on the other hand, when you go to Maharashtra, Ajanta, Ellora, the hills and the historicity of the caves. So there, and you name any dimension of tourism, whether it is adventure tourism, culture tourism, medical tourism, you name it, India offers it. So it's a subcontinent of 1.5 billion people, which is 1/6 of the humanity. So if you don't visit India and you say, I'm a tourist, you have missed something, really.
Yeah, exactly.
You understand?
Exactly.
So that's the point I'm trying to make.
Yeah.
And for bridging that information gap and giving that familiarity about India, there is a responsibility also on the media, on the travel agents, travel promoters.
Yeah.
Not, of course, the governments have to do their bit, which we are doing, and provide the connectivity, as the Undersecretary was saying. That is responsibility of the governments with regard to visas, with regard to connectivity. But at the same time, to enhance the familiarity and information, bridge the information gap, we depend on the media, we depend on travel promoters. So that's the objective behind this seminar.
Yeah, sir, वहाँ पे एक ऐसा भी था, एक बहुत अच्छा plus point आया. The plus point is what the under secretary has given us the to make a deal with India and government and for the tourism. It is one of the good sign,
yes,
also, you can say.
Yeah, we welcome that and we will work on it.
Yeah, thank you, sir.